Wouldn't it be nice to be able to select an area of the Earth and simply take it and put it into Minecraft? I mean, yeah, you could build it block by block, but that would take for ages. Today, I'll show you how to do that much, much faster and easier. Spoiler alert, we'll need this know-how for future episodes where we rebuild Dubai on a real scale in Minecraft. So without further ado, let's get right into this tutorial. So there are several websites you need to visit. I put all the links in the video description below. Mainly you need the SRTM Tile Grabber, then one of those two, and World Painter. We start with the SRTM Tile Grabber. That's basically, if you open the link, it's basically this globe. And you can see those red squares. You can select the place you want to have in your Minecraft world. I, for example, I'm taking Dubai. So yeah, we're running into a problem because Dubai is somewhere within these four. I'm not 100% sure if it's in this square. Maybe a tiny part might be also in this or this square. So yeah, basically we download all four of them. So we click on it and click download. Yeah, simple as that. And let's do this with the other four as well. And now it's important which operating system you're using. If you're on a Windows computer, as I am, then please use this website. It's called microdem.org. I put it in the video description as already mentioned. Though if you're using a Mac, use this page, also in the video description. This is the one for PC, this one for Mac. I'm using a Windows computer. So yeah, I'm downloading from this page. Basically, we head down there and we select the well first and click on it to download it. There you see it's getting downloaded. Now, when you try to open this file, it might be that there will be like this message. It's in German, but translated this means, yeah, that my computer thinks it might be a malicious software that I'm trying to open, which it is not. So basically what we're gonna do is we click on more information below here on this link, and then we're able to open it anyway. It might be you're not getting this message at all, but in my case I got it. So yeah, we just open it anyway. And we click on yes. And it's installed. So basically we've downloaded those four files for those four areas. And when we look at it, we have several files in these zip files. And we don't care about these three, but we do care about the first one, the TIFF file. But if you open them, yeah, you get this black and gray image, and that's not actually what it should be. Let me show what it should be, basically by opening it the correct way. So we drag and drop it out of this zip file. We do this with all of them. So now we have those four TIFF files. Basically, we go to the first one and open it with MicroDem or with SimpleDem, depends on what you're using. And as you see, it didn't work for me, but that doesn't matter because we can import it again. If you have your MicroDem open, just head to File, Open, and open the merge dem grids, very large, and so on. Click on that and we select all of them, open, and yeah, wait a bit. Here we go. And now we see we have, first of all, our map, but we also have like all these lines and stuff. And actually that will cause a huge problem later on. So what we're going to do is we disable them by right-clicking and legends and marginalia. I click on it and we disable all of them. What we also need to do is clicking on grid and deactivate this as well as this one. Clicking on OK. OK and close. So then we right-click again. Click on the first one, display parameters, and click on elevation. And now we need to change it to grayscale. And then we click on OK. So, and now we have it everything monochrome. And what we need to do is we need to adjust some of the heights. Later on, the white part will be the highest part, whilst the black parts will be the lowest. So, and what we need to do is we check which of these is the highest. We hover around. And I found this spot 4162, but it may be somewhere, maybe even higher. Okay, I think that is the highest over here. Okay, and the lowest, that might be here somewhere. Okay, so and now we click again on display parameter and again on elevation grid values. Again on grayscale and set range. We click on specified and for the minimum let's take 0 and the highest. I mean, that should fit actually, 4472, that might fit. So we click on OK. And again on OK. We see this whole thing like on around 8%. But we need 100, and this is really important. We need 100%. And so we click on 100 and we let it load a bit. So we have it on 100% now, and now we can export it. Therefore, we click again on File and on Save Map as Image. And we click on this with grayscale. And yeah, type something to Dubai, for example. And save it. And so we have this now. And yeah, we can move on to the next step. So, and now we got one problem, and that's the white part over here, that's the sea. And yeah, as I mentioned earlier, white means highest point. So this gray, this light gray is higher than this black, but the highest is the sea, and it doesn't make sense at all, right? I mean, it should be the lowest. So what we're gonna need to do is change the sea to pitch black. We do that by using an image editing software like GIMP. It's a free software and we only need to change white to black. Let's do this very quick. Open it in GIMP. So what we're gonna do is we go to selection, select it according to color, and we select the white. And yeah, I've got this one. We need to put that to 0. So only white gets selected. And now we have the problem that over here, for example, that we also have some very, very white. And we only need to put this to pitch black. Yeah, but that's the solution therefore. But first, you might ask, why don't we just use the magic wand over there? Well, the reason is pretty simple. It's because, like, if we would use the magic wand, so the problem is, like, sometimes we have, like, some lakes or something, or, like, some areas of the sea surrounded by land. Which means that those won't get selected because they are not attached to the white, to the other white stuff. We have selected everything white and now it's time to use our brush, 100% transparency, and 100% of those two, and we choose pitch black and much larger. And what we're gonna do is we color it. And yeah, make sure you have the transparency set to 100%. And then, yeah, you can simply color this white area. And you see, you can already see, you won't be able to color anything of the non-white area. But pay attention to, for example, not color over here, because there are also some white areas. Yeah, that should be it. Let's export it very quick. So, and now it's time for our third website, which is World Painter. So yeah, download World Painter for the operating system you have. I've already downloaded it, so let's open it very quick. So yeah, it should look like this. And then you click on File, Import New World, and import it from Heatmap. Look for the file you've made previously. For me, it's the Dubai file, and open it, and it looks like this. And yeah, you see the blue stuff, that's water. And this over here, that's the coastline, and behind the coastline and the coastline itself, it's all water, and that doesn't make sense, right? That's because we haven't adjusted these numbers yet. So let's do that very quick. So yeah, you saw I put the lowest point to 64 and the water level to I put the lowest level to negative 64 and the water level to negative 63. So yeah, I put it here to the maximum. And now we only got to do one thing, and because this is green and Dubai, as we all know, is in the desert, we need to change it to sand. Here you could also apply the theme, for example, for negative 64 you can put sand, and there we take also sand. We could do that like this, and now we can also adjust, for example, the height limit, and we do that by going to edit and change map format, and here we can change it to, for example, this one, 1500, or no, let's say 2000. That works. And over here we can also go to the dimension properties and set a border for the edge, like I put barrier. You can also choose one of the others. I put barrier because, yeah, I think that's the best option in my case. Yeah. And now let's see how it looks like in Minecraft. Therefore we go to File, Export, and Export as new Minecraft map. Here you can do some settings. So now simply put your file into your saves folder. If you have trouble finding this, hit the keys Windows plus R, type %appdata%, hit OK, and there you have your Minecraft folder. Open it and somewhere there it is. There is your saves folder. And here is your world. Open it and see if everything is correctly. And yeah, we are in the desert and we are in a mountainous region. That's at the very top of the map. Now let's find the sea. I have no idea in which direction I need to go. There it is. There's the sea. That looks pretty nice. I hope you enjoyed this little tutorial and be here when we rebuild Dubai on a real scale in Minecraft in some months. We start with this new project. I don't know when exactly, but it shouldn't be that long. So for now, all left to say is bye bye.